The women have held center stage for the past two matches. Zhang and Zhao, followed by Xi Jinping and Lu Lan. And now the thunder, the blood and the guts of the men's doubles as we see our umpires for this one. Eddie Rufianto of Indonesia, followed by Christian Johannessen of Denmark. And he'll have a real smile because of Denmark's success in these championships here earlier today. Now this could be fireworks to finish off a great tournament. Normally we expect some great firecrackers before and after an event. Maybe we'll get firecrackers during the event, because both these teams are capable of extraordinary drama. Chai Yun and Fu Haifeng, we've seen them over the years absolutely electrifying the public. The left on the right of screen there is credited with one of the fastest, quickest shots, the speediest shot that ever was measured. It's something in excess of 330 kilometers an hour. Whether or not the Koreans are coming out now, Jung Dae-sung and Lee Yong-dae can combat that with their extraordinary defense. Korean defense is legendary in doubles. Lee Yong-dae, the youngster at the back, is already such a huge name in the world of badminton in Korea because of his achievement as Olympic champion in the mixed doubles. Silver, of course, as well in the men's doubles, and silver in Kuala Lumpur as well. It was just extraordinary the way he came as a teenager through to the big time. And I must say, a lot will be dependent on Lee Yong-dae, whether his total confidence will be backed up by Jung Jae-sung's defense as well and great net play. We will see. A huge amount of anticipation here. Both of them have come through to this stage with a great battle. There's no doubt at all that Chai Yun and Fu Haifeng can feel themselves fairly lucky that they're here, because they came mightily close to losing out to Zakri and Fairoz Izwan of Malaysia in the semi-finals. We've got a little bit of a distraction there on court at the moment, or by the side of the court, but I'll do my best to battle through and tell you a little bit more. Zakri and Fairoz Izwan against Chai and Yun, Chai and Fu, were just so close. They were 21-18 up, and it was 22 all in the second. But in the end, Chai and Fu found something special to take that second game and went on to win it 21-15 in the third. There's Eddie Rufianto, hugely experienced umpire, and I'm sure most respected umpire, and we will not have any trouble in this one. Lee Yong-dae and Jae-sung, meantime, they also had a great battle. And Koo Kian-kiat and Tan Boon-hyung, two Malaysians in the semi-finals, and everyone was expecting at least one of the teams to get through. Eventually, they won out in the third, 22-20. It was the most dramatic, unbelievable men's double semi-final. So both of them have come off big, big three gamers. And I don't know whether ultimately that will have an effect on the drama that will unfold before us. Maybe it will. We will see in just a while. Men's doubles, it's going to be the fifth and final match of the World Championships here in Hyderabad. And I'm sure, looking at our roving camera here, coming around, picking up the spotlight and the action right in front of us, there's great anticipation, and hopefully we'll see some spectacular shots from these great exponents of the game. Chayo, Chayo, I can hear already, there's the Chinese supporters. Chayo, more oil, more aggression, more fun. China have had their fair share of success, and I'm sure that the Koreans in the crowd will be hoping for a bit of a miracle as well. Seeded four in this world event, Zhong Jaisung and Li Yongde. Five in the world, Chai and Fu, but do not be fooled by that, because Chai Yun and Fu Haifeng know how to win. Fu Haifeng is the lefty, everyone else on the court is right-handed, and I'm pleased to say Jill Clark has not gone to the airport, she's still with me. She is going to give her expert opinion on what is building up. In fact, listening to the crowd here, they have been looking forward to this one immensely. Whether or not it is the big one, I don't know. I made reference earlier to both the semi-finals. Take us through the other matches there, Jill.
Well, yes, I mean, no real problems prior to semi-finals for both of these pairs. I have to say that they've only played each other once in the last 12 months, and that was the last Super Series event, the Indonesian Open. And in the final of the Indonesian Open, in fact, it was the Koreans that won on that occasion in two straight games. So, despite all the experience and the fact that the Chinese are former world champions, the fact that the Koreans won the silver medal at the World Championships 2 years ago, well, I think I've got my money on the Koreans. That's bold, I know, but...
No, I don't think so. And you know, I managed, well, I was fortunate enough with you, of course, to witness that semi-final. And they showed the character. That's what it's about. The determination, the depth of character to fight their way through. Korea's doubles pairs are legendary in their fighting ability.
The other thing that perhaps we ought to look out for, if this match gets really tight, sometimes the left-hander Fu Haifeng does struggle with nerves. He can get very nervous indeed.
The target there, the right hip on that occasion of Yongde. No. One through the legs, but Yongde couldn't match it. Good accurate play at the net and control of the net. We keep saying it, but it is the game of doubles. Control of the net will be the most important thing. 3-1 China. Signal being given. See if we can work out where it goes. And that is absolutely amazing. No, it's a foul.
Service fault is called, racket not pointing in a downward direction. Oof, yeah, that was flat, wasn't it?
Immediately raised the hand. Good judgment there from Christian Johannesson. They've got a lot of support here in this crowd. I'm really, really quite surprised at how much the Koreans are supported.
Well, interesting, we didn't actually see it, but I can tell you that Fu Haifeng, immediately after that rally, went and spoke to the service judge and said, "Well, you called me a fault, why aren't you calling him?" And the umpire has just had a quick word with Fu Haifeng as well and said, "Look, just let the service judge do his job."
Yeah.
Terrific angled smash from Jung Jae-sung. Thundering that down towards the forehand defence of Fu Haifeng, and if there's a weakness with the defensive play of any of these men, I guess it is the forehand defence of the left-hander. Very much their favoured formation as far as the Chinese are concerned. The big hitting Fu Haifeng at the back of the court. Dai Yun at the front, finishing off the rally.
Well, the lefty does miss out there. Had the chance, tried to kill it, but I'm intrigued by the really aggressive positioning of the Koreans on receiving of the service. You should see, it's just long. It's a five all. You should see how aggressive they are in setting themselves for this receiving of the serve. They're both crouching. Well, let me just have a look. Maybe it's on the, this is on the old court, so no, it's not quite as spectacular. On the even court, it's much more close and tight than that. Good defense, China. Good defense, China. They're not used to so many smashes and it coming back so hard frequently. It's 6-5, and listen to this crowd. That's good to hear. We haven't heard that passion in the Gajapoli Stadium since the Indian players themselves were on court.
String's gone in the racket of Jung Jae-sung. Chinese pair, of course, won the All England title in March earlier this year. Lee Yongdae, of course, was not playing with Jung Jae-sung. He was on military training. Had to take 3 months off from international badminton to do his military service. Oh, going for the tight drop shot, finding the net. The youngster, Lee Yongdae, is 20 years of age. Can you believe it?
Hugely disappointing. Wow, it was on a plate there for Jae-yoon. He didn't take it. 6-8, that will make a difference. At the net there, Jung Jae-sung was absolutely dead and buried. Ooh. 9-6, and already we're seeing a pattern developing here. Jae-sung, whenever he goes deep and gets up with that very, very high smash, if he's off balance at all, he has been putting it net-wise, and I think that would be a cause of concern. The Koreans, their whole power play relies on Jae-sung being on song. Do you think the fact that they lost out in Kuala Lumpur in the final will give them more determination? You see, again, he dips out. We know how good Lee Yongdae is. Jae-sung sometimes comes under pressure.
Yes, and the fact that he's been away from the tour, he's had to miss some play this year because of having to do his national service in Korea. I wonder whether, you know, obviously the more you play, And the more you win, the more confidence you gain. And the fact that he's been away from the circuit, yes, of course, he and his partner won the Indonesian Open. But, you know, the more you can win, the more confidence you get. Oh, careful confusion there. Oh, that's so good, Wang Kaiyun. I can remember when they won the world title as they go to the mid-game interval with a five-point advantage, the Chinese pair. I can remember when they won the world title back in Madrid in 2006, they absolutely blasted their opposition off court. That, of course, was Anthony Clark and Robert Blair of England.
It wasn't funny. It was very, very tough to take. And we sat there. I remember we were right by the court side. Do you remember, Jill? We were not up high where we are here, looking down from 35 meters away. We were right court side, and we were looking into the eyes of the bench, of the English bench there. Oh dear, it was so tough to take. Chaiyun, well, by reputation, he had the big, Fu Haifeng had the big hit, but between them, they were just totally, totally dominant. It's a much tighter, closer affair here, but they still have, they can go back and relive that experience. They can look at that experience when they're talking about setting up for this final. They know that they have that talent. 11-6. They're going well here, the Chinese. Ooh, dear. It's not just Jaisung making errors.
No, it's. I was watching very carefully at the mid-game interval there, John, and the Chinese have got two coaching staff, Lee Yongbo and Chang Jun, and the Koreans one coaching staff, Kang Kyun-jin. All the coaching staff from both teams are world championship medalists themselves. You know, nowadays in badminton, the coaching staff are a who's who of former champions. And when you've got people like that advising players who can relate to the experience, know what it's like to play these big matches, these big occasions, you know, it's no wonder we're seeing such terrific matches and such terrific play.
Yeah, absolutely. They go through the strategies, they look at the options, and then improvisation on the court is much simpler. But at 7:13, this is must-get time for Yongde, and Jaisung has the shuttle. Pressure. Big pressure.
No, it's just long. Fascinating in the middle of that rally, the fact that Jung Jae-sung was getting kept at the back of the court. The Chinese were just lifting to him at the back. And at one stage, Lee Yongdae said, literally turned to him and said, come forward, I'm going to go back and do the smashing.
That's exactly what happened.
Yep.
Good work, good thinking, good looking. 8-13. But by golly, it's really, really athletic, this stuff. Look at this. Ah, super shot, cross court. He took him unawares there. He'd been playing everything else down the middle or down that line. This time, cross court, into the hip, too tough.
Yeah, once again, forehand side of Fu Haifeng found wanting.
People cannot understand how that unbelievable jump. That's good, yeah, on the line, it's 10-13. The way that they can jump and deliver, well, just amazing. This is a good fight back, Jill.
Yeah, they were 6-13 down just a moment ago, four straight points. But that run comes to an end. Such aggression.
It came from the service, didn't it? The receiving of the serve. They were absolutely onto it. It wasn't the worst serve, but wow. Followed up. Kept pushing back. 11-14. This is going to be a fantastic matchup. It already is. Uh-oh.
Shuffle struck above the waist, says the service judge, Mr. Johannesson. Well, the definition of where the waist is, of course, interpreted differently by every court official. And players do seem to come very, very high nowadays.
Just as you thought that the Koreans were going to fight back in this. Couple of very quick points for 16-11. And Cha Yun at the line. Super touch. The big hit. The big hit. And that's out. It's 17-16. That is great doubles play.
Yes, classic. Hit down the centre. Get your net player involved. And now a 6-point advantage. Oh, that's good. Very, very good play from Lee Yong-dae. Wasn't only the placement of the shot, it's the fact that he moved forward at exactly the right moment, really anticipating so well.
And he knew it was the lefty trying to get the shuttle.
Yep.
Clever. ...12-17. Still a huge battle here for Korea to come even close. That's one of them. 13-17. No. 18-13, but again back to that old very simple method, a quality service, but big support from both players there, both behind and at the net, finished off easily for 18-13. With a signal there from Fu Haifeng, coming short again.
Unbelievable. He really does read the game so well, and to me what is so extraordinary about that is the fact that he is so young. Normally for badminton players to mature and really learn how to read the game and anticipate so well takes years and years in the doubles discipline. Here he is at the age of 20 and he's reading the game like an old master.
Olympic champion, of course, in the mixed doubles, but there, woohoo, that was a jump, drop shot by Cha Yun, and it was just perfection, 19-14. They survived that second game against Zakri and Fairuz Izwan, and now taking huge advantage of that opportunity that developed from it. 15-19. The Chinese former world champions will certainly not let this one go. It's an error, it's 2015, and China's Cha Yun and Fu Haifeng have game point this opening game of the men's doubles final here in Hyderabad, World Championship. It's in. Unbelievable. We've said many times that if Jai Sung can do those miraculous shots, you see him so many times from the base, why doesn't he do it when they've got a chance of winning the game?
Yeah, well,
yeah.
$1 million question.
Oh, well, of course. But at 16-20, it's all too little too late. But I think it shows, Jill, that he feels the pressure. You know, no pressure then when you're 20-15, is there? Absolutely no pressure.
No.
You know you're not favourite to take game, but he does something absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, you might as well go for it. Go
yeah.
for broke.
It's out, 17. And the sympathetic crowd here in the Gachibowli Stadium giving Korea huge encouragement.
Well, that's interesting. Umpire has said that Lee Yong-dae was interfering with the shuttle. I think he was just trying to smooth the feathers, but he said no, you've got to take a new shuttle, don't want you doing anything to the shuttle that might be to your advantage.
Still three game points to China. That's out as well. Great fight back. Wow. 18-20. Here's me saying that it was a lost cause, but the Koreans proving me, not unusually, totally wrong. 18-20. One more and it'll be interesting. Still game point. He's the big boy. He's the winner. 21-18. Fu Haifeng comes up with a ripper when it's needed.
Terrific opening game, but in all honesty, the Koreans just let the Chinese pair get too far in front and they just couldn't close the gap.
Chayun, Fu Haifeng, former world champions, 2006 in Madrid. Ah, there they are, not holding hands quite. A little smile from Xi Jinping, silver medalist Lin Dan, the majestic, historic world champion for the third time. Ah. Good to see. We don't often see them side by side. They've now come out, as they say. One love, China. True love, China.
Well, so much for my prediction that the Koreans were going to win this final.
You don't know yet. It's not done yet.
No, absolutely not. There's still a long, long way to go. It's a good return of serve. But it's going out. Oh, my goodness. You're not serious.
He is serious.
Oh. Lee Yong-dae turns to his partner and says, for goodness sake, that was going a mile out.
What are you doing, my boy?
Now, if ever there was a sign that the player is struggling with nerves, that was it.
Yep.
Panic.
He said it several times. It's all down to Jung Jae-sung. This time he passes the test, but it could have been so different.
There's definitely some Korean fans, isn't there? Here in the stadium, waving the Korean flag.
Keep the faith, Jill. I'm not as disappointed as you are at the minute because I think the Koreans have this extraordinary resilience. Okay, Jae-sung's mistake, but by golly, he's an extraordinary athlete. There you go.
The commitment of Lee Yong-dae at the front of the court. They're launching himself forward. Look at this. In an effort to play that kill. That is commitment.
Three in a row to fight back to the all square. And another one, and it's Jae-sung that does the business. They're now in the lead in the second. I've just got a good feeling about this one, that will go all the way to the wire. We'll be both screaming and shouting at the end. We've seen the best battle in the world final for a long time. Four all in the second, having lost the first, the Koreans have a must-win situation here. I should have gone to the soothsayer or whatever they have here in India. What's the, you know, predictions, fortune teller, to tell us how long we're going to be here on court. I think it's going to be quite a time. 5-4. He was so keen to kill that, he got absolutely too involved with the shuttle.
Yeah, total miss it.
Korea, having gone three love down, now hold a 6-4, and now a 7-4. Great service, Jill.
Yeah, and seven of the last eight rallies, that is impressive. And I think that the youngster on court, Lee Yong-dae, is the key to this final.
No doubt at all. Sorry. No doubt at all about that. He has impressed me every time I've seen him, not just in his own tournament, but, you know, of course, he teams up with Lee Ho-jung, and they put on a great battle. She sometimes can be a little bit indifferent. He's also got Jae-sung, whose form can be inconsistent, but he himself, Lee Yong-dae, is totally the cement that keeps them all together.
Yeah, there's that little half-court push that I've been talking about so often during these championships. And doubles so effective, get it past the net player.
Good, super stuff. It was a wonderful rally. Great men's doubles. Both pairs absolutely locked horn to horn. Wonderful stuff. Enjoyed that one, Jill.
It was absolutely tremendous. I mean, if ever there was an example of how to build a rally and work the rally to get the net player involved, that was it. Absolutely superb.
Well, we always like to see a rally finishing with a positive result, not an error, and that was the perfect way to finish it off. Excellent stuff. 9-6, and again we say watch out for the Koreans.
Oh, once again
service
above the waist, says the service judge. Well, I think the thing, in all honesty, as a player, it's not necessarily whether that was a fault or not. I mean, what annoys the players is the inconsistency between one service judge and another. So the court officials don't always have the same opinion. Now, I haven't seen Lee Yong-dae faulted throughout these World Championships prior to this men's doubles final. Immediately makes amends though, and that shows great character. He was annoyed that he'd been faulted on his serve, and immediately the next rally, and look at the reaction after he finishes. Yes, he says.
Spectacular rally for 10-7. And that is 11-7. They go to the interval in the second. And the Koreans have announced their arrival back in this match. It has been a really entertaining first 11 points achieved. Listen to this crowd. I am really so impressed, and I'm over the moon. They're giving us an atmosphere that this matchup deserves. The championship has come in for some criticism around the world, various quarters. We've been here, we've had our moments, but I can tell you now, delighted to be here witnessing the curtain match, the final match of this 2009 championship, and it's living up to expectations. 12-7 Korea.
Ooh. So steep with the shot coming down, Kai-yun. Haven't been talking much about Fu Haifeng in recent rallies, have we? He needs to get himself involved more. Yeah, well, we'll talk about him in a negative way after that shot.
Notoriously strong at the baseline. Loves to spend his life there, whacking them down. But with a little bit of a deft touch required, he was far too heavy-handed. Good on him there. Well, I was going to say good on him there for coming forward. But again, it's into the net. It's 14-8. And it, once more, it's celebration time for Korea. Doesn't matter, they nearly missed each other with the high five. It's really good stuff. Oh, easy. 15-8.
It's absolutely amazing to me how... Do you remember that indecision, dreadful indecision from Jung Jae-sung on the backhand side when the shuttle was going well? And I said, if ever there was a sign that a player was nervous, that was it. And how the Koreans have transformed themselves from that position. Because quite frankly, it's one-way traffic now in the second game, and it's in favour of the Koreans. And I thought, after that woeful backhand that Jung Jae-sung had hit, that things were looking fairly bleak for Korea. But terrific character that they've come back in this way.
Here, here. Well, he's hit a woeful backhand there to the net for 9-15, but that six-point advantage, it's huge at this stage. Lee Yong-dae, okay, he's only 50% of the team, but look at that for the net shot, giving himself a chance here down the middle. Big stuff. It was, oh my goodness.
How on earth did he get that back?
No idea.
This is a big point. Absolutely extraordinary. There was a defensive shot early on in that rally from Kai Yun. I thought the rally was over, quite frankly.
I called it over, Jill, so you're absolutely right.
Yeah, and I think that the Koreans, you know, probably said to themselves, they were probably surprised and felt that the rally had already been won. You know, and sometimes an extraordinary shot like that in a big match like this can actually change the momentum. We'll see. Well,
yeah.
No, it hasn't changed the momentum. But, I mean, again, that's showing good character by the Koreans.
They play these shots and they're all over the place in terms of their body shape, you know, balance. It goes out the window because they have no time to adjust their position. All they've got to do is to try and get as much power and timing into the shuttle and then the strike and the placement, of course. And they really can put their bodies in all kinds of different positions. 16-10 Korea. Oh, you beauty. Rushing the net as a duo. Now, was that an error or was it a planned move?
No, that was an error.
17-10, whatever, it worked.
Now, we haven't seen that sort of Chinese setup within the rally for some considerable smash from Fu Haifeng at the back of the court. Finished off at the net. But I suspect it's too little too late in this second game to come back. Okay, things can change very quickly in men's doubles.
It's 18-11. Each point is celebrated, and why not? They'll be disappointed with the way in which they allowed the Chinese to dominate that first game. This is different. The middle, classic splitting the pair. 12-18. Well, he is the big hitter, but he needs accuracy, and that was woefully short there. 19-12, the Koreans will force a third and rubber game here in Hyderabad. He's been called a couple of times, wondering whether he should play the backhand. But the luxury of still a six-point lead. Which is some threatening. Is that great play or what? Amazing, it's out. It's 20 points to 13, it's game points aplenty for Korea. But didn't they deserve that deal, the defensive way they played?
Yeah, absolutely. Really have transformed themselves.
Just listen again. We haven't heard the crowd like this the whole day. It's just cool. Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo. It was so tight to being out. I think it was on the line. Not that one, but this one coming up. Right on the corner.
That was, he couldn't have gone over and placed it with his hand better than that. That was absolutely wonderful.
True. It's 14-20 because the Chinese will be serving to Chayun.
And I don't think that the court has been mopped sufficiently. Yeah. I can see from here the perspiration still on the court surface makes it a little bit slippery. And the last thing we want with such a terrific final is for anybody to have an injury.
Perspiration. I will say sweat. It's 14-20, whether it's perspiration or sweat, there's heaps of it. Bucketfuls out there. It's 15-20.
Now, once again, Lee Yong-dae getting caught on that high backhand. But the reason he's getting caught is because he's encroaching in on the net. He's trying to threaten the front of the court, which he's right to do.
Uh-huh. 16-20. That's a real brave fight here. It was the story, more or less, of the first game, where the Chinese held a supreme position and the Koreans fought back and gave them just a moment of concern. It went to 21-18. It's still game points and it's done now. 21-16, Korea in this World Championship men's doubles final. It's one all in games. We will fight to the death. The music pounds here between the second and the third game of the final matchup in the World Championships in Hyderabad. My mind just wandered a little bit because I was hearing Hezbollah, my RTM friend right next to me, and I'm just thinking, The Malaysians, all of you in Malaysia at the moment just watching this, you have my sympathy, because I think at least one of your teams should be here. And you think what Fairuz and Zakri must be really witnessing this and thinking, if only. Kuantan the same. It is a fantastic game, wonderful match, but Malaysia so close, yet now so far away from the drama. Korea will serve. It's in. Wow. Jai Sung on this occasion comes to the rescue, puts in a beautiful shot deep.
John, it was interesting to me in the timeout there between the second and the third game that Lee Yongbo, head coach to the Chinese team, very rarely actually given any advice to any of the players during these championships. He's left his coaching staff to be on court, and whilst Lee Yongbo has been sitting behind this match the whole time on the coach's bench, it's one of the first occasions he's actually stood up and given his players advice. Now, that to me is always a sign that he's not wholly confident that his players are completely doing the right thing.
Or ultimately delivering.
Yep.
1-2, an error on the play there. It's far too flat from Jung Jae-sung. It's in. Yongdae splits the pair, 3-1. Now, if they do romp into the lead here, it will send a huge message, because most players like the other end. Is that skillful? That was brilliant touch play by the Green.
It was absolutely wonderful. Absolutely determined not to lift the shuttle. And a great lesson that it's not always the power play. They were just guiding the shuttle in a downward direction, waiting, pushing, probing with the shuttle until they forced the error.
Defense is good. Oh, he played it on his bottom. 2-4. There's loads of drama here. Yeah, your point, Jill.
Yes, there is Lee Yongbo. We saw him, the coach with the hat. Of course, he was world champion twice, world men's doubles champion back in 87 and 89 with Tian Bingyi.
Oh, 5-2. The Chinese duo feel the pressure, I can tell. You can it's coming out of their very pores because of the pressure that Korea are putting on them. Look at that defense, it's extraordinary. Amazing shot! Oh, wow, Chai Yun, you savior.
Yeah, it was absolutely brilliant. There was a shot earlier in that rally that Hu Haifeng was at the front of the court, and yet he didn't really play anything positive. And that to me is a sign of, you know, I keep saying, well, he's so brilliant at the back of the court that he might as well play in the area where he is so brilliant, but he never looks that comfortable at the front of the court to me. And that's why they're always trying to work Kai Yun forward like he did in that rally.
That was excellent. He's put in a couple of fantastic shots. 1-2 points, very important points at 4-5. The drama continues, and I can tell you, really, you'd be a crazy person to actually predict this one.
Well, I already have. I must
yes,
be crazy.
Yes, you did, but no. But
oh, that's terrific.
That was just for a bit of fun. I'm talking about in reality right now, it is really even, Stevens. Yeah. 5-all, third game.
Yeah.
Wow. Anybody's.
I have noticed a couple of times when the Chinese pair have won a rally, Kai Yun especially, is turning round and looking at his teammates in the crowd and showing them with a clenched fist as if he's saying to them, you know, come on, I can feel the crowd are supporting the Koreans. Come on, team, get behind me. There's no doubt that the Chinese teammates are behind him. No question of that. There's great team spirit amongst the Chinese players.
It's only just, but what an extraordinary athletic ability that was from Li Yongdae. How on earth did he leave it? Just look. Oh.
Yeah, it was long by
amazing.
A whisker.
Yeah. See the way he keeps his racket up, Jill, just
yeah.
like you've taught him. Oh, short. And who is it? Jai Sung, knowing that they have had the chance to really create a gap. And he's not quite there like Li Yongdae is, 6-7. All you youngsters, we keep saying it, we mean it. Racket high if you're at the net. Good work for 7-all. There's some passion here. It's not quite Istora Senayan in Jakarta, but it is just something now akin to an atmosphere. 1-all, 7-all. Is 7 your lucky number? Jill nodded. Jai Sung's defence is not quite good enough.
Isn't it interesting the way that now, from this near side of the court, it's the Chinese who are doing most of the attacking. We saw that in the opening game. In the second game, from this near side, as we're looking down on the court, it was the Koreans who were doing most of the attacking. It's got to be the influence of the drift, surely.
Yeah. Well, if they stay in touch at the half, at the interval, which they are going to do, because that's 8-all. If they stay in touch, I think the Koreans, coming to this end, will ultimately be favourites. Oops, snatch, missed. 9-8. It was behind him, Jill. That's why it was too fast. Like that, the shot that you've been talking about.
Absolutely. That little push that just goes past the net player and you tempt them into trying and playing it. Oh, that's superb.
Are they the best in the world? Oh dear. Well, I think actually these four players are playing as if they believe they're the best in the world. That was absolutely extraordinary.
Not only technically to be able to play that brush across court into the open space, but for Kai Yun to see the gap there. When you've got your opponent rushing towards the net, inevitably you get distracted by that as a player when you're standing there, and 99% of the time it puts players off to see a player approaching the net like that. But it didn't put Kai Yun off. He just calmly guided the shuttle across court into that open space. Absolutely brilliant.
You will forgive us if we're getting a bit carried away with our compliments here, but it is something special we're witnessing. 10-8. Oh dear, 11-8. They are just about still in touch. When I said about changing ends, in touch, I was thinking more in terms of 10-11 or maybe 11-9, but at 11-8, I don't know. Korea are really fighting. But can we see a 20-year-old as Olympic and world champion? Ooh, that's a big call. Isn't that wonderful? The Chinese sitting there with Indian friends, they've newly acquired friends, having an absolute ball. Independence Day just a couple of days ago, and they're still in party mood here in India. It's 11-8. The Chinese, former world champions, have got the service, and it's Fu Haifeng at the net. Long serve. Oh, and it's
service
a
fault called. Double action, says the service judge. Well, goodness gracious, we saw that in the mixed doubles final.
I can't recall, Jill, a service judge being involved so much on a final day of a world champs.
No, nor can I.
Haven't seen as many as you. It's wide, it's 10-11. And watch out now, Korea on the march. I don't know what it is, they just love this side of the net. Something about it. Three in a row, 11 all. It's not just the Koreans who love it, it's all teams. This is where success has come. Oh, short.
It was so desperately close.
It's wide, it's 12s.
Look who they're smashing on. They're really attacking and pressurising Fu Haifeng. Even aiming smashes cross-court to make sure they hit it onto the left-hander.
It's good strategy. That's what you would have advised.
Yep, indeed.
Ooh. Jung Jae-sung just looking back to see whether he felt he should have left it. Have a look at this. He looked back now, there. Ugh.
Decision. I think it was going to land in.
Definitely.
So it's over. 13 all.
Now it's all about who handles the pressure. There is so little to choose between these two pairs, technically and tactically.
I'll go Korea. And that's why. That is why.
Yeah.
14-13, thumbs up all round. It really is. They're arrogant with it, but I tell you, it is just stunning double play. This is fantastic entertainment.
What a return. Goodness me.
Yu Yongdae puts them back in it.
This is a big point.
Oh, a snatch from Jae-sung. He's not the weak link, but he is a link that we all worry about.
Yeah, he's the one that I think will struggle with the nerves.
14 all.
Yeah, Li Yongde needing a new racket.
Well, it's a match befitting a world championship. We said this could be one that goes to three. Both of these teams have played three games in their semi-finals. So energy levels, I guess you could say, might be of interest to us. It might be worthy of a comment. But actually, the adrenaline bubbling along like this through the veins, you're not going to be worried how tired you are. This is just stunning.
No, not at all. And even though Li Yongde has also played mixed doubles.
That's right.
Two events, only player on court who's played two disciplines here in the World Championship, but it won't be affecting him, not at all.
14 all. Oh, that's out. It is. Yongde was just looking. Oh,
15,
no.
14.
Jai Sung, come on. You could do better than that, my boy. 15-14. It's still a fool's gamble of bets here. Oh, 16-14. Caught unawares
16.
There.
Yeah, I suspect that Li Yongde, knowing that his partner has been struggling with nerves and has made one or two errors, I think Li Yongde tried to take a shot there that normally he wouldn't try to take. He's trying to get involved too much and take over some of the work rate from his partner. Got to trust your partner. Got to believe in them.
Oh, it's short, and a snatch at the net by Chai Yong. Keeps careers hopes alive.
16.
Look at this crowd, the cutaway there, the guy saying, oh, excruciating. It is really tense. It's fantastic match. 15-16, and Li Yongde will serve it. It's like a cricket match in the middle of India here. You've heard of cricket, Jill, haven't you? You've played it, don't tell me. Good fun, whatever. It's 15-16, Yongde. It's, yes, it is out. What a call. What a huge call.
Well, Chai Yun is saying it touched his shirt, appealing to the umpire and saying the shuttle touched Li Yongde's shirt on the way through. Oh, gosh, couldn't tell from that. And I wasn't even watching the shuttle land there. I was trying to see whether the shuttle had touched the shirt.
I think the call was good from the line, but, well, how do you tell whether a feather has actually touched the shirt like that? 16 all. Oh, wow. Short, but how on earth did that come back? 17-16 to the Chinese, but that was some millimeters. It hung up there to dry. You're going to put a peg on it. It stayed so long. Unbelievable. What do you reckon he's thinking?
Oh, Kang Kyun Jin never shows much emotion, does he?
17-16, China. It's a magnificent stage for a wonderful piece of drama. 18-16. Little nod there from the Chinese bench, but I tell you, their tummies will be churning as well. Well, I said before this match started, I hope I'll be screaming and shouting at the end of the third game. I've nearly got my wish. Defense of China, superb. Look at this.
Fu Haifang dropped his racket on the ground in the middle of that.
Tell me that you don't like badminton and I'll show you the door. This is absolutely superb, wonderful, extravagant and extraordinary entertainment. Can you believe what is happening, what is unfolding in front of us? 17-18, of course they deserve a towel down. They are the gladiators of an extraordinary matchup here. Wow, Jill.
Well, Li Yongbo looks very calm and collected there. I wonder what he's feeling inside. Okay. But it's a pity we're not seeing a replay of the fact that Fu Haifeng dropped his racket on the ground, realised that his partner had got the shuttle back, grabbed his racket again, got back on court. Just absolutely extraordinary. Play. Just 1 point in it. Oh, that's amazing shot. The vision to see the gap across court kept the shuttle so flat over the net. Look at that.
20 years old, nerves of steel, talent beyond anything we've seen in a doubles player for many a year. At 18 all, that Korean youngster, Lee Yong-jae, it's no wonder he's a film star. He is absolutely front page everywhere he moves in Korea. This is exactly what we hoped we'd see. We started out slowly in this competition, in this tournament, and even today in our finals, but we're ending up with an absolute firework. It's in! What a shot! Unbelievable! 1918 China, look at this! You'd think they won it already. Yeah, where was he?
But once again, I think perhaps Li Yong-jae shouldn't have tried to intercept that because he was trying to do too much. His partner had already moved to the backhand side and therefore the huge gap across court. But wonderful, wonderful play by the Chinese. All credit to them.
We are in the final of the men's doubles of the Yonex Sunrise BWF World Championship. 19-18 in the third to China. It's out! It's 19-all! And the crowd on their feet, and it's no wonder. I feel like doing that myself. We all cover many sports and many tournaments, but we all want the best to give us the best. And this is absolutely right down our dream list. It's out! It's 2019! He hasn't won yet, but you'd think he had, the way he celebrated that shot out long. It is 19. World Championship point to China. Listen to this crowd. Korea still in it. They are 20 points all. Oh my goodness. My little dream angel asking for a fantastic final here in the World Championship has delivered everything I asked for. It is superb. When on earth did we get a men's final coming to this stage and this critical level of excitement? 20 all in the third. Wow. It is in! No! Yong-jae, the hero.
Plum on the line. Good call by the line judge.
Fabulous. And very nervy one, but my goodness, he delivered. He did his job like all the line judges during this tournament. It's now up to the Chinese, and there they are. Look at the king and queen of, or princess, And the Prince of Badminton right there from China, equally as passionate. World Championship point, China. No, not yet. 21 all. Look at the reaction of the Chinese team members there in the crowd as well. This is stunning. You can play this again a few times during the year. It's just amazing. 21 all. Li Yongdei will serve it. A little turnaround. He keeps it short.
Yeah, served out wide. That was clever.
Spectacular. It's short. Ho-ho! And Zhong Jiasheng points to the heavens and says, yes, now we're here. Help us. Help us to deliver. And the... Do you know, look at that, he points up, but all the press photographers have come down to the Korean end now. They have moved their position. 22-21, sensational end to a really unbelievable week here in Hyderabad. Jiasheng jumps, he rocks from side to side. Li Yongdei delivers, but it's not there yet. It's 22. 22 all.
22 all.
Oh.
And the court will need to be mopped after that dive from Zhong Jiasheng. But he didn't move his feet at all, just dived towards the shuttle.
You don't mind me getting excited, Jill, do you?
No, this is absolutely terrific.
22 all, look at Lin Dan, world champion three times over. He knows what it takes. He knows how much heart and soul is in this. 22 all. Good pickup.
Oh!
What a rally! What a rally! It's out of court! It's now, for the second time, World Championship point to Korea. And can you believe nerves of steel of all four players there? That was quite phenomenal. I have never seen anything like that, Jill.
It was absolutely tremendous rally. You could just sense the tension out on court, the intensity of every single shot. But having saved two match points now for the Korean pair to have a second championship point themselves. Well, you said this would be difficult to call, and so it's proved.
If you don't watch men's doubles anywhere else on the planet, replay this one. It is fantastic.
That's short.
Not yet. It's 23 all. That pressure from the Chinese, their heart is as huge as it comes. They have been giving it, they've been taking it, and I tell you what, the balance of power at the moment is absolutely so difficult to call. It is a balance. You don't know which side of the scale is going to tip, but you can rest assured one thing, neither team actually deserves to lose this. 23 all in the final of the World Championship here in Hyderabad.
Well, Li Yongdei wants the shuttle changed. Kai Yun says no, but the umpire has said yes, indeed, change it. No, in fact, the umpire has said I think the shuttle is fine.
Okay.
And a little bit of psychological games going on there.
Odd court, Chayun. Oh, it's a brilliant service. You absolute beauty. Goodness me, look at that. Xi Jinfeng, Lin Dan say magnificent.
Well, the Koreans are appealing to the service judge that it may have been a false serve, but he didn't call and he can't make the decision later. It has to be an instant decision.
It's 24-23. It is World championship point for the third time, China. And it's in! Oh no, what a shot! Leon Day, does he have any nerves? Unbelievable, look at this! Oh, how close, how tight. 24 all. Gosh, there were moments when I thought, will this tournament ever come to life? We've had some dull matches, but what a way to finish. Oh, service fault called. 25-24. Wow, Li Yongdei called for service fault, and that really is, we've said it so many times during this match already, we have never seen so much intervention from the service judge before. But Christian Jonasson of Denmark comes up with an absolutely crucial decision. World Championship point, China. It's out. How many times can I actually say this is the best World Championship match that I've witnessed, let alone the fact that it's in a final. 25 all in the third. The Koreans have a chance through Jung Jae-sung's service to get back onto that top step of the podium. Not yet though. I've lost count, Jill. Is that the fifth or the sixth World Championship point for China? Fifth,
this,
I think.
This will be the fifth.
Yeah. 26-25, whatever happens, we have been treated to an absolute dream final. Oh, look at Chae-yoon again. He's now serving from the even court. He's against Yonday, who puts in a beautiful drop. Pressure on Korea here. Oh, it's short again. Oh my goodness me. 26 all. Oh, wow, sit down, Lin Dan. You've already won your championship. You don't have to go home quite yet. He can't take the pressure, and he's sitting out in the stadium. What excitement, Joe.
What did I tell you about his worst watching? It's more nerve-wracking watching than it is actually playing. 26 all.
Yongdae. He can do it here. He has not done it here. It's gone. Sick World Championship point to Fu Haifeng and Chae-yoon, and it will be Fu's serve, I believe. Chae-yoon. Yeah, I thought it was. They've changed over now. Well, we haven't got it in shot there, but they have changed. And it will be Fu Haifeng with the service. That's it! China have... Oh, my goodness, how can you believe that? They were world champions in 2006, and they've done it again here in Hyderabad after the most unbelievably thrilling final. It has just been amazing. 28-26 in the third. You cannot beat that for sheer willpower, determination, skill levels. It has been a huge thrill and privilege for all of us.
Well, having saved two championship points to come through and convert on their sixth opportunity. You're right, John, it was an absolutely thrilling encounter. And an hour and 15 minutes of the best men's doubles. Li Yongbo comes onto court to congratulate his players. But I think something you said earlier, that it's tragic in sport sometimes that there has to be a loser. And on this occasion, for the second world championship running, Jung Jae-sung and Li Yongdae have to settle for the silver medal. They're just confirmation of the score. What a match that was.
Well, all the crowd here have been treated to an absolutely sensational sporting occasion. I don't think and I've covered for 30 years, I don't think that I can put that much below maybe the fourth or fifth or perhaps the sixth biggest and most eventful and most exciting match that I've covered. It was quite extraordinary. We will wait for the prize presentations. There's going to be some interviews on court. And as I come down off my high, I know that the Chinese will be so, not just so relieved, they'll be delighted that they came through against the ultimate resistance. The Koreans know how to fight. Li Yongdae will definitely, at the age of 20, come through, and I am absolutely convinced will take this title at some stage in his career. It's not quite his time and place yet, but the Olympic champion in the mixed doubles, he did his absolutely level best to be here and to be at the top of the podium. That will not quite happen for him now, but China, again, have been dominant. I must say, Jill, that that Chinese dominance, although some people say, what do you expect? You have to say, these are individuals, they're humans, they've come from sometimes very humble backgrounds to get to the top of this world tree, and you have to hand it to them. They have done an extraordinary job throughout this week.
Yes, they certainly have, and it's not just the individuals. I know it's an individual sport, but the system that they have in China for producing champion after champion after champion is just extraordinary. You know, four titles to China, emulating what they managed to do at the World Championships in Madrid in 2006, three gold medals at the Olympic Games last year, and four gold medals here at the World Championships. You know, It's not just a one-off. Ever since they have been competing in world badminton, and they came into world badminton in the early 1980s, and their first ever world championship in 1983 in Copenhagen, they'd got gold medals there. And especially the dominance of the women's singles and the women's doubles, has been absolutely phenomenal. But, you know, when I watch men's doubles like this, and the speed and the skill of all four players on court, you know, you talk about other sports that you've covered and so on. To me, I'm a great sports fan, but I know people will say I'm biased, but goodness me, how can any other sport match that?
It was simply superb. Okay, we're nearly ready for our prize presentation as we conclude the highlights of that match. But how do you wrap up in such a short period of time the best of the best? It was just, in every respect, quite excellent. There, the final moments then of the Chinese victory, and it was not just relief for China, it was something really special for all of us in the sports arena and our coverage. Well, we're privileged to be here, no doubt at all. Let's concentrate our minds now on these final moments then of the presentations, where we've got Malaysia and Malaysia celebrating the fact that they got through to semi-final stage. Zakri and Fairuzi's run there, and also of course Ku Kien Kiat and Tan Boon Hyung waiting there to receive their trophies, their medals, the bronze medals there, being presented by Dr. Kang, the actually, Dr. Kang will come forward in just a while to make the presentation, but we believe that Claude Jeannot, the regional manager of Longines, one of the sponsors of this World Championship, is also there to make the presentation. I know we saw Dr. Kang a while ago, and I know he's there, but congratulations to Malaysia. Better luck next time, and that next time will be in Paris. But you can see them smiling here at the moment. Zakri there putting the medal, or his medal, around his neck. Great bronze medal in a world championship. It's a huge thing. Fairuzi's run right there as well. And that was a tremendous effort. And there, representing Longines, as I say, Claude Jeuniau from the famous watch, Swiss watch company. And here we have, well, put your hands together. What a battle. It wasn't scripted. It's what we hoped for. What an absolutely superb pairing that is. They gave us everything that we wanted. Drama, excitement, some elements of disappointment. Jai Sung perhaps didn't have his A game there. Yong Dae, perhaps, as Jill said, tried to take on too much responsibility sometimes. But what do you expect from an enthusiastic 20-year-old? He will at one time, I'm sure, be a world champion. But save just a little thought now for the former world champions, their unbelievable determination to come through served them well in the end. Chai Yun and Fu Haifeng of China, now with huge smiles, will come to the top of the Yonex dais there in front of us. They are used in this part of the world. There are the wonderful duo, although they're singles, of course, in their own disciplines, the wonderful duo of Lin Dan and Xi Jinping, applauding what has been a supreme sporting effort. They are obviously exponents here in India of great drama on the film stage, Bollywood. You wouldn't have scripted anything better in Bollywood than what we've just witnessed. It's been superb. And there, Chai Yun and Fu Haifeng deserve the plaudits, deserve the congratulations. And of course, everyone here is thankful for a really fantastic match. It's quiet. The calm after the storm. Wow. The VIPs will come now into the center of the photograph for a great picture. It's quiet. The fourth time that we've heard the national anthem. We were absolutely enthralled in Beijing, but I tell you, what we've seen here today, after an unbelievably tough time during this week in the setting up of this tournament, ultimately, do you know what? Sport has won out, Jill.
Yes, it certainly has, and you mentioned early on about the controversy at the start of the championships. I want to forget that. I want to remember these final matches, and certainly today, to me, the outstanding performance of the tournament, which has culminated in a gold medal today, was the Danish mixed doubles. They have beaten world champions, they've beaten Olympic champions, and they have beaten the top Chinese pair on their way to taking this gold medal.
We've been here, privileged to witness this today. Fantastic final day.
What a befitting end with that fantastic match of the men's doubles to wrap it up. That went really down to the wire. But I think that just sums it up. China have dominated proceedings as was expected, winning four of the five disciplined titles that were up for grabs today, the men's and the women's singles, the men's and the women's doubles. It's only the mixed doubles where the Danes managed to pull off what was a fantastic win. That really were the giant killers in the competition. But that's all that we have for you as far as this live telecast of the Badminton World Championships is concerned. As of now, this is Raman Banod saying goodbye to all our viewers on behalf of the entire production team of Doordarshan for this event.